love is in the air. Everywhere I look around, love is in the air. Good afternoon and welcome back to this week's WIKE News Show. We're your hosts, Bridget and Paige, bringing you your afternoon announcements.
Teachers, please place your recycling bin outside of the classroom on Fridays so that the students can collect the recycling more efficiently.
Students will have no school on Monday, February 21st, President's Day. The makeup days from our recent snow days will be Friday, February 18th and Friday, May 27th. Club and class news. Middle level students. Information on Warren County Youth Baseball and Softball registration will be coming home with you during advisories. See the office if more details are needed.
News from Guidance Office. See the Guidance Office for scholarship opportunities.
Athletic news. Winter sports are now in session. Best of luck to our winter athletes.
Now on to night walking.
We're here with Tucker to ask him questions about Groundhog's Day. Did Phil see his shadow today?
Yes.
Correct.
Hi, I'm here with Haley, Abe, and Winnie. And how many times has Phil guessed for an early spring?
12.
27.
36.
It's actually 20.
I'm here with Chris and Derek. And what does it mean if Phil has seen the shadow?
More winter. Snow.
Six more weeks.
We're here with Sean, and what does the meeting Punxsutawney that was given to the town by Native Americans mean? I'll give you a sentence. Town of the blank.
Town of the free.
The correct answer is mosquito. Here with Garrett, and we want to know what day is Groundhog's Day.
February 2nd.
That's correct.
Love is in the air. Everywhere I look around.
We're here with Abe and Sydney, and what is your favorite Valentine's Day chocolate?
Russell Stover's.
Anything Dove.
That was a good choice.
Just text.
We're here with Abby, and what do yellow roses symbolize?
Friendship.
I would guess friendship.
That's correct.
Okay, we're here with Lucas Martin, and when did the Candy Sweethearts get their shape?
Like the year?
1942. 1901, sorry, that's incorrect. We're here with Haley and Gracie. My question is, what type of flowers did you guys want for Valentine's Day?
Roses.
Tulips.
Nice.
How many heart-shaped boxes of chocolates are sold each Valentine's Day?
7.5.
What?
8.5. 9. 14 million. I don't know.
Oh my 35 god. Million.
That was my next guess.
Now for a special Valentine's Day segment with Jordan and Lydia.
I am Jordan here, bringing you a Valentine's Day dessert segment.
We're here with Mrs. Criswell, and she's going to try one of our chocolate covered strawberries.
I do love chocolate covered strawberries.
Does it matter which one?
No.
Okay. I'll be nice and leave the big one for someone else.
Well, I would say it's delicious, but my students would tell me that it's gas.
Now on to Mental Health Minute.
Welcome back to Mental Health Minute. Hannah and Taylor here. Being alone on Valentine's Day isn't always a negative thing. Take some time to love yourself this year. Here are some ways to enjoy your Valentine's Day.
Go to a movie. Going to the movies alone is arguably better than going with someone else. Get a ticket to a new film you've been dying to see. Splurge on some overpriced popcorn and candy.
Host a singles-only dinner party. Spending time with friends is a great celebration of love that doesn't involve romance. Invite all your favorite single people over, cook an amazing dinner, and celebrate with your friends.
Plan a date with your best friend. Best friend love is something to celebrate. Get dressed up, go to a fancy restaurant, and celebrate your friendship.
Is that what we're gonna do?
Yeah.
Okay. Stay in and pamper yourself. Make it a day full of self-care activities that make you feel rejuvenated and refreshed. Take a long bath, do a face mask, or paint your nails.
Do something nice for someone. Choose someone who is older than you, like a grandparent or a mentor. Send them a bouquet of roses and tell them how much you look up to them.
Stay off social media. Make Valentine's Day a phone-free day. Stalking your ex on social media to see how they're celebrating with their new significant other is not going to make you feel happy or confident, nor are all the happy couple photos clogging up your feed. Buy a new book to read instead or spend time in nature.
Buy yourself flowers. Buy yourself a beautiful arrangement of flowers or bring home an assortment and channel your inner florist and make beautiful bouquets. Use them to decorate your house and bask in the sweet smell.
Love yourself. Do whatever makes you happy. Cut yourself some slack. Remind yourself that you are lovable and worthy of love.
This Valentine's Day, make sure to take time for yourself and remember, romantic love isn't the only love to be celebrated.
That's all for this week's afternoon announcements. Have a great day and
stay classy, Eisenhower.
What's up?
Hi.
With Lydia Larson, and what would you like to receive for Valentine's Day?
Someone who loves me.
When people don't answer your questions,
good luck, Charlie.